Don't go inside. It's very dangerous. Thank you.
awesome. That's perfect. Don't worry. I'll take care of making this into a pie shop here in a moment. We also need to fill the pie with something pretty nasty. What we need first is a raw crayfish. I want you to go and get one and bury it in a field. Just shove it right into the dirt and then let it ripen for a bit. Just use either the flax field, wheat field, or the animal pen for the job. The flax field is closest. It's in the northwest of here, near the master farmer's shop and the well. And don't forget, when you are done, you should come and see me and show me your work. But first, let me take care of that flower for you. Okay, see you about. The fish biting. Oh, Saratoga, that thing stinks. Just looking at it makes me want to vomit. Perfect. Only one thing left. To give the pie a little more body, we'll add the potato. I want to go and get a raw potato and shove it down a kebbit hole. If you don't have a potato, and head farmer Jones might well have one you can use. Kebbit burrows are full of hair and droppings and all other kinds of nasty waste. So if you just shove it in there and pull it out, it'll be okay. Well, I say okay. Okay, see you about. Ugh, that thing stinks. I'll never eat that unless we do something to mask the smell. I have an idea, though. One of Rollo's fellow merchants, foppish Pierre, has been hanging around the mill. He carries a supply of spices on him all the time. If you can pickpocket those, then we'll be in business. So, just go and grab those spices from Pierre and add them to the pie. Then you can take it up to Rollo and see if he swallows it.
Dressing me. Oh dear, this will never do. I was right, this will never do. I mean, look at yourself. How, by any stretch of the imagination, am I supposed to converse with one such as yourself? You are so lower class. I've become used to dealing with better people than you since I became fabulously wealthy. Thank goodness I have my pomander of expensive spices. Your odor was beginning to make me feel lightheaded. I'm sorry. I can't hear it when poor people are upset. Toodlepip.
How are things going? Is it about what to do next? Because all you need to do is go up and give the pie to Rollo.
Watch me! is this? This is not the scrumptious red berry and distressed quail pie I demanded. Well, that's not my problem. Maybe he didn't torment the quails for as long as I specified. But whatever this is, it does smell delicious. Oh, really? Then I suppose I might try a portion. What is it called? Squishy crust-belly filler? I can't say I've ever heard of a squishy crust-belly filler before. To make up for not being able to make the pie I ordered. Well, that's quite nice of you. Tell the chef I will only sue him slightly for not making what I ordered. And that if this pie tastes nice, then I might even pay him for it. Thanks. What for? Yes, yes, that's all very well and good. Now be on your way, you jabbering vassal. I am a pie. Crust-belly filler, eh? See what it tastes like.
Rolo certainly won't be causing any more trouble for a while. Don't even talk about that. I'm still queasy from seeing what he did to the stairs as they carted him out. They had to sluice them down with buckets and mops. Oh, terrible. But at least the stains are all gone now. Well, with Rolo out of the way, you can go up and steal the seal from his chest. We'd best move fast, in case he decides to send for it when he comes round. Is there anything else you need to... Okay, see you about. Get this letter stamped out. now. Done. Now just take it to Pierre, and we're home free. Don't forget to come back and see me when you're done, okay?
Open the food stalls for free? Is he demented? I have to contact some people. Leave me to my despair.
There is that. Hopefully the food situation will improve, unless someone else muscles in on the racket. Good point. But for now, let's celebrate.
to my humble abode. How can I help? Well, I do have something you could look into, although I don't know if I would call it a quest as such. But if you do have some time free, could you look into the whereabouts of my two assistants, Scalectrix and Bolovtrix? Well, they're only slightly late compared to poor Felitrix. Actually, they are quite late. I sent them out this morning to gather supplies, and they have not returned. It is a little worrying. They were over by the old dry well in West Taverley, opposite the water mill. Could you take a look for me? Oh, I do hope so. Thank you, my lad. Summoned familiars are spiritual animals that can be called to you from the spirit plane to serve you for a period of time. These animals can also perform a special move, which is specific to the species. For example, a spirit wolf can perform the howl special move if you are holding the correct howl scroll. Charged items contain summoning power, but in a stable form. They can be used to physically store any scrolls you have. Those are the main effects of summoning. Are you still following me? I can supply you with pouches and spirit shards, but you will have to bring your own charms and secondary ingredients. Many creatures drop charms when you kill them in combat. There are many different charms in the world. Gold, blue, green, crimson, and even some specialist ones like obsidian. The best way to raise your summoning level is to infuse pouches. You will still learn a little from summoning a familiar, as well as using a scroll and transforming the summoning pouches into scrolls. But nothing is more potent than infusing a spirit into a summoning pouch in the first place. Do you understand? Good. Where was I? Ah, yes, the last part of summoning. The pets. The more you practice the skill, the more you will comprehend the natural world around you. This is reflected in your increased ability to raise animals as pets. It takes a skilled summoner to be able to raise some of Gielinor's more exotic animals, such as the lizards of Karamja, or even dragons. Now that I've given you this overview, do you want to know about anything specific? Summoned familiars are at the very core of summoning. Each familiar is different, and the more powerful the summoner, the more powerful the familiar they can summon. The animals themselves are not real, in a sense that you and I are real. They are spirits drawn from the spirit plane. As a result, they have powers that the animals they resemble do not. They cannot remain in this world indefinitely. They require a constant supply of energy to maintain their link to the spirit plane. This energy is drained from your summoning skill points. Your level of the summoning skill is not drained, and you can refresh your points back up to your maximum level at an obelisk whenever you wish. Yes, that is an appropriate analogy. The more powerful the familiar, the more it must feed, and the more food it will need to be satisfied. As a result, only the most powerful summoners are able to maintain a link from a familiar to the spirit plane. Since they are able to provide more food with each summoning level they gain. As you gain mastery of the skill, you will be able to have familiars out for the full time they exist, and still have some points over to re-summon them afterwards if you wish. This is because you are able to feed them the energy they need and have leftovers to spare. Oh, why not ask me to count every blade of grass on a lawn? The familiars each have unique abilities, and even the most experienced summoner will not know them all. Well, some familiars are able to fight with you in combat. They will keep an eye out to see if you are fighting, and will intervene if they can. Other familiars will not fight for various reasons, but they may provide bonuses in other tasks. Some will even carry your items for you if you need them to. Would you like to know anything else about summoning? Charged items are very simple to create. If not, then you can simply buy a set of antlers or a lizard skull from me. You can take an item that can be charged, usually a headdress, and attach scrolls to them. The scrolls are then stored in the headdress. Aggressive combat scrolls, however, are the only ones that can be used in this way. Well, a scroll in a charged item will only be activated when it is hit with enough power. Since this can only happen from the impact of combat, it makes sense that only combat-based scrolls could be stored here. The activated scroll will then be sensed by your familiar, and it will defend you. Oh, nothing too serious. Stabbings, explosions, arrows to the torso, that sort of thing. Oh, come now. A strapping lad like you will barely feel it. Your opponent, however, will certainly feel the power of your retaliation. Anyway, one impact is not enough. It will take a series of strikes to activate the power in the charged item. No. As with the normal method of instigating a special move, the correct scroll is required for the correct familiar. Even if some dreadfoul scroll power was hanging in the air, a spirit wolf would not be able to do anything with it. Only if you've made them shoddily. The items should be useful for a long time. When you run out of charges, you simply need to attach more scrolls. Would you like to know anything else about summoning? Summoned familiars are at the very core of summoning. Each familiar is different, and the more powerful the summoner, the more powerful the familiar they can summon. The animals themselves are not real, in the sense that you and I are. They are spirits drawn from the spirit plane. As a result, they have powers that the animals they resemble do not. They cannot remain in this world indefinitely. They require a constant supply of energy to maintain their link in the spirit plane. This energy is drained from your summoning skill points. Your level of the summoning skill is not drained, and you can refresh your points back up to your maximum level at an obelisk whenever you wish. Yes, that is an appropriate analogy. The more powerful the familiar, the more it must be, and the more food it will need to be satisfied. As a result, only the most powerful summoners are able to maintain a link from a familiar to the spirit plane. Since they are able to provide more food with each summoning level they gain.
Yes? How did you know that?
Well, I would have come back, but Bowl of Tricks has been captured by trolls. I've been waiting here for someone to come and help me.
They're in this well, but don't go in there. There are way too many to handle. We need something to keep them at bay or break them up. Something that will scare them. I tried using a spirit wolf, but they just laughed. The leaders seem immune to the howl of the spirit wolf. But without something to thin their numbers, we'll never get Bowl of Tricks back. Please, sir, can you let Pickup Sticks know what has happened? I'm sure with your help he can come up with something to drive away these trolls. Be careful.
More food come to us.
Wolf bones think you're not gonna last long.
Especially not if we cut them into little bitty bites.
Please hurry.
What's the plan? The plan. The plan to save Bowl of Tricks. Oh, could you please hurry up?
Welcome. Then you go on. Spirit creature that can generate an aura of fear so potent that even a horde of trolls will flee in terror at its approach. Usually, such a summoning would take a circle of experienced druids, but we have to clear out that horde before they attack. We will begin immediately. I need you to bring me a few things. I will need you to bring me my ancient wolfbone amulet, some white hair meat, and an embroidered pouch. I will also need to give you a blessed spirit shard and a gray charm. The amulet should be with my assistant, Sticky Mix. He took it from White Mountain, which is the large range from the west of the family. The hair meat is available from the pet shop, which is on the bottom floor of the building to the south of here. The pouch is lost somewhere upstairs. I managed to lose it in a rather violent kerfuffle. And of course, I have the last two items here when you are ready for them. I gave it to my assistant, Sticklebricks, when I sent him over to White Wolf Mountain to bring me some wolf fur, for luck. Although now I come to think of it, I haven't seen him in a while. What day is it again? Anyway, I'm sure you'll find him in good health. White Wolf Mountain is to the west of here. You will need to cross the river at the bridge to the southwest. I'd suggest taking some food. There are vicious wolves there. If you see one, then just run past it if you can. The pet shop owner in town is some. They import it for some of the more pampered pets, although to be honest, more of it ends up on the plates of pet owners than in your. The pet shop is on the bottom floor of the... I would go and get it myself. Well...
Yes, I do. I stock it as a treat for the animals, but some people round here snap it up for themselves. Waste not, want not. I get it imported from a very reputable trapper in Mauritania called Rufus. He always knows how to get the best meat for the animals and ships it pre-skinned, boned and cut. White hare, basilisk, chinchomper, veal. Well, if it's an emergency, I suppose I can let you have some. I hope things work out for you. Is there anything else I can help you with?
How can I help? use the hunt. Of course. Remember, these are extremely rare and precious, so I plead that you take good care of them. I hope you're right. These are very valuable relics. I see what I've heard about you is more than true. You've got everything right here. And now, before you go running off, let me do something. I have some spirit helpers who sometimes do tasks for me. In this case, I just ask them to make sure that these items don't return to me if they get lost or damaged. Now, all you have to do is go and infuse them with the obelisk metal. You won't have to worry about picking which pouch to make, as you know exactly what to make from these items. Well, you should come over here and let me inspect your work. You never know what could go wrong with such a monumental summoning effort like this one. Hello there. Welcome. What is it you need? Well, you need to take those items over there and infuse them at the obelisk to make them into a giant Wolpertinger pouch. I think that about covers it. Do you need any more? What is it you need? Well, you need to take those items over there and infuse them at the obelisk to make them into a giant Wolpertinger pouch. Hello there. Welcome to my... Have you done it? You have the pouch. Phenomenal! I knew I sense great things in your future, my assistant. Come, let me see it. I had never thought we'd have needed one of these in my lifetime. Well done. I think you are ready. Take this to Scaletrix. With her help, you should be able to summon this spirit beast and rout the trolls. No, no. The energy needed to summon this beast is too much for just one person. Even with the pair of you, it will only last a few moments. But Scaletrix is strong too. Between you both, you should be able to accomplish this.
Thank you.
You're back. What's the news? A giant Wolpertinger pouch. I never thought I'd see one. With just the two of us, it'll be a stretch, and we'll only be able to summon it for a few seconds. But that might be all the time we need. This is it. Get ready.
It's the girlie that had the wolf. We got more druid meat for the big fight, lads.
Yes, feel the true power of the druids.
A big bunny! That's not scary at all!
It's scaring me! Why is it scaring me?
Leggett! It's gonna eat us all!
It's messing with wolf meat brains! In my head! Make it stop!
Wolf bones need it, mummy!
Yes, the Wolpertinger won't last long. In fact, there it goes. Oh dear. I hope he's all...
Thank you both. I was a goner until you showed up.
Well, he's the one you should really be thanking. Without him, we'd never have been able to call the Wolpertinger.
Yes. Thank you very much, hero.
Especially as that means he'll be able to come back and help with Pickup Stick's next project.
Well, yes. Oh, how I
Poor man. Go see the healers before you faint. Maybe he was in such pain he wanted to get there quickly. Anyway, he's alive and well, all thanks to you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I have a worthwhile quest for you, actually. You have about you the air of a wandering hero, and I sense you can aid us. You are aware, are you not, that we worship Guthix, the god of balance? Well, anyway, we wish to contribute our strength to those soldiers who are fighting to protect us. However, Guthix sits in balance on the matter. All the omens show that he favors neither side more than the other, because on a global scale, the trolls' chaos and disorder are relatively minor. In Taverly, there is a herbalist, Sanfew. He is researching a potion we can offer to Guthix to bring our plight to his attention. The trolls represent disorder. For us, it is a major, immediate imbalance of the elements of harmony. But we need to call upon Guthix to right it with all haste. The potion is specifically called the Ointment of Imbalance. If it is applied to the stone, it will call Guthix's attention to our plight. Once he sees the chaos the trolls have brought, he will turn his power against them, and our star will once more be in the ascendant. I would ask you, hero, to go and help Sanfew with whatever he requests. With your help, I am sure we can create the potion and perform the ritual. Excellent. Go to the last house on this side of the riverbank to the south of Taverly and speak to Sanfew, who is working on the potion for the ritual. He knows what is required to complete it, thanks to his studies.
What can I do for you, young'un? Have you now? Well, aren't I the lucky one? You may be good at bashing trolls, young'un, but this will take a little more thinking for you to get done. I've got a list of things I need you to retrieve for the potion. Don't you go worrying about mixing it up. Just leave that to me. Now, let me see. What was it I needed again? I remember. I need you to get me a vial of untainted living water. Here, I'll even give you a vial as you seem to be lacking one. After that, you can get me some wandering wormwood. And while you're by the lake, you can catch me a stonefish and get some of the scales. It's said that there is a spring of living water. I've heard some trolls have gone and mucked about with it, but what really
is untainted by whatever modern hookah they have brought. Just take a vial and fill it up from that water source. That's all you need from there. The magic in the lake to the south of Cavalry makes stonefish appear from time to time. The pebbles at the bottom of the lake just up and start swimming about, and before you know it, they've turned into a fish. They love gold, so go down there and bait a hook with a gold coin, and you'll be sure to catch one. I don't need the whole thing. Just scrape off some of the scales with a chisel and let it go free again. It said just tip. Well, thank you very much. So nice to see some polite young people around for a change. Did you bring me the required ingredients for the potion? Oh, that's the stuff. Now, did I ask for the whole fish or the scales? No, I just need some scales. Chip some off with a chisel and let that poor fish go. Trouble with your memory, eh, young un? I blame all that loud music and fancy dancing you'll not get up to. I need you to catch me a stonefish from the lake last I heard. Well, thank you very... Did you bring me the required ingredients for the potion? Whoa, that's the stuff. Well, now I think about it, you've got it all for me.
Right, let's get this potion sorted then. There we go. Now take this back to Cake Mix at the Stone Circle and we'll be fixed up and ready.
Gothix, Lord of Balance, hear us. In the name of all beasts and plants, from the humblest mouse to the mightiest of dragons, from the tiniest blade of grass to the tallest oak.
What are you gabbling about, young Cake Mix? The ritual just calls for you pouring the ointment on the stone. Are you trying to put us all to sleep?
Well, forgive me for trying to add gravity to the ointment.
Accept our sacrifice, Gothix. Witness our devotion.
Well, did it work?
Prayers have been answered.
Guthrix's will has turned against the trolls.
Well, this calls for a celebration. Oh, where's the mead?
Don't forget, these notes must be exchanged at the back for the real items before you can use them for your own studies.
Hello, citizen. How can I help? We do have a quest, if you believe that you are ready for it. The trolls have taken up a position on Death Plateau, and we can't move them. As you know, the trolls have been pushing us hard, and we have to do something before they get too dug in and begin sending forces down the pass. They have stone throwers lining the only path up there that we know about, and the only entrance is narrow and easy to hold. If I didn't know they were pretty much mindless animals, I would almost admire the position they've taken. Well, no. Sending you alone would be suicidal. What we need is to find another way up there. If we can find another route, then we can try and ambush them or just spy on their movements. There's a cave beyond the defensive wall to the northwest, at the foot of the plateau, where you'll find a dwarf called Sabbath. He's a surly old geezer, but a good ally. He and his wife were surveying the mountain before the trolls arrived. To get there, go northwest from here, then west past the tower and the ruined wall. Then turn north, and you can't miss it. If you go and speak to him, I'm sure that at the very least he'll be able to tell you another route up to the plateau. We really need you to help us, with some urgency. It will be dangerous, and you may have to face some combat. Can you do it? That's great news. May the gods grant you speed. Hello, citizen. Is there anything you'd like to know? Welcome to the Principality of Berthor. We are the Imperial Guard for His Royal Highness Prince Anlan. Is there anything else you would like to know? You are right, citizen. The White Knights have taken advantage of the old and weak king. They control most of Asgarnia, including Falador, but they do not control Berthor. We are the prince's elite troops. We keep Berthorpe secure. The White Knights have overlooked us until now. They're pouring money into their war against the Black Knights, so they're looking for an excuse to stop our funding, and I'm afraid they may have found it. If we cannot destroy the troll camp on Death Plateau, then the Imperial Guard will be disbanded, and Berthorpe will come under control of the White Knights. We cannot let this happen. Is there anything else you would like to know? Of course. What is it you need to know? I would start by speaking with Sabbath, the dwarf that lives in the cave not far from here. If you go northwest of here, past the defensive wall, then his cave is to the north. It leads under the plateau. You can't really miss it. He and his wife were scouting the mountains for a suitable location for a trading post when the trolls arrived. To get there, go northwest from here, then west past the tower and the ruined wall. Then turn north, and you can't miss it. It's very likely that he may have a good idea where to find a route up to the plateau.
Hello? What are you after? Ambush the trolls, eh? That's an idea. First good one I've heard the guard have in a long while. But it's not my problem, so I suggest you take your fancy talk elsewhere. Well, try not to get in me way, because I'm not going to help you. Fine. Fine. really not going to move, are you? All right, I'll help. If nothing else, I don't want you standing there watching us while I sleep. Well, if you want up there, you've got two choices. The first one is you can try the airy, fairy, lackluster, shoddy way, clambering over the rocks like some cross-eyed goat. Faffing around like a fool, scrambling about hand over hand, foot over foot. Nobody's meant to get around like that, man. It's demeaning. Ah, the proper way. Under the rocks. Hard away, man. The trolls might be thick, but they'll spot your cart and rubble out by the ton. No, what you need is to break into one of the natural caves under here. That'll sort you out. Then you can enjoy the wonderful sport of caving and potholing. Ah, the great feel of scrambling hand over foot through dark, dank passages. Bliss. Well, I didn't get much time to do anything but make some notes before the trolls came. I bet Frieda had time to put them all together. She's a bit soft in the head from all the living on the surface, but still a canny lass when it comes to geology. You can't miss her place. It's a little house to the west of here. You just need to follow the only path in that direction, and you'll get there. I don't know why she keeps to that place when we have a nice comfy cave right here we can turn into a proper home. It's you lot that I blame. All your gallivanting around on the surface has turned her head. Aye, see you later then. Watch your heed on the way out, mind. Oh, it's you again, eh? What you after now? Cave? Cave? This is no cave, you idiot. This is clearly the entrance hall to the trading post I'm going to set up with me wife once the trolls are gone. We're going to have some shelves over there and put the storeroom over there. Aye, well, blame the missus for that. The second the trolls came along, she packed all the tools up and moved into a fancy darn little cottage. But not me. I'm not shifting for some stupid trolls. It's them or me. And I'm winning so far. One day, they'll all be dead. Then I'll work this place into a proper little home and shop. Then who'll be laughing, eh? I heard that. No. 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 I don't need you. Or your fancy tools. I'm a dwarf. If I can't do it on me own, then I might as well not bother. Do you think I'd be stuck in this hole, fighting trolls with me bare hands and teeth, eating moss and chipping the walls with a stone if I didn't think I could do it? These trolls aren't gonna beat me. I'm gonna outlast them. And when me wife comes to her senses, she'll come back and we can set up together. Aye, we'll set up this little shop just like we planned. And no trolls are gonna stop us. Oh, is it now? Well, get yourself off then. Watch your heed on the way out, mind.
Hello? How can I help you? What do you want that for? Oh, he would go telling you that, the old duffer. There are some. But he doesn't understand that humans like you prefer running about and climbing over things instead of digging around. Ah, yes, that sounds about right. He's always hated it, ever since I managed to get from Rimmington to Taverley overground faster than he went underground. He tried going overground himself next time, slipped on some snow and ended up bashing his shoulder on a rock, bless him. Anyway, this survey. I can make a start on it after I get back from town, so you'll have to wait for me to be done with it. The survey we made is written in some very technical terms, and I'll need to dig out all the information for you. Well, I could, but I really need to get my climbing boots re-spiked. If I don't have that done, I might run into trouble if the weather turns. Oh, that sounds like a pretty good idea, your own. I'll make a start while you go take care of this little job for me. Just go and see Dunstan. He knows how I like them. Good smith, that man. But for a human, obviously. In one of the houses to the east of Burthorpe Castle. His is the one in the middle. In fact, it would probably be quicker if you used the home teleport spell. It saves you running all the way there and then all the way back. Thank you.
Hi. Did you want something? Hey, these are Frida's boots. Where did you get them? Well, I suppose so. There you go then. Here are your boots. Hi, what can I do for you? All right, speak to you later then.
I just finished it about a minute before you walked in. You've got a good sense of timing. That's grand. I'll take them off your hands. Here's the report. Nah, you're all right. He'd not accept it anyway, the stubborn goat that he is.
Oh, what's this? Looks like the wife's done a nice simple version for you to follow. You human, give it here. I see. That's it. All you need to do is dig over there. Looks like there's a weak point behind the rock that'll let you into the caverns. Hey, watch it. You humans don't know how to mine cleanly at all, do you? Excuses, excuses. Hey, take these. Frida keeps sending us them. She knows I hate tomato. Those caves will likely be dangerous. And even if you make it to the other side, you'll face some trolls. So, either I leave them to start stinking up the cave, or you eat them. Either way is good with me.
Hello. Eyes the map. Yes, I've got the map, so me and my mate can have a look around for ways to get down to Human Town for the fighting. Big Boss made it, but then I ate it. Yes, then the other trolls say mean things. Look, it's the stupid troll. He's so stupid, he eats the map. Then they all call me the map from then on. I've lost. Me and the lad, we was looking for a way down to Human Town. The boss, he said, you carry this map I made and go down to fight. Then I eat the map and all the others get angry. And now I is lost. I eat you, human!
Can we use it to get onto the plateau itself? Ambush their reinforcements as they come through the choke point. I love it. We'll thin their numbers and give our troops on the front line some respite. Come, let's plan a little surprise for the trolls. You've done great work today. That went very well. When you're ready, those archers will need some crates delivering to them. We have a number of reward lamps for you, if you want them. We have pinned them down, thanks to the vantage point on the cliffs that you found. They can't reach us with rocks, nor climb up to attack. We can rain arrows down on them with impunity. Friend, we are indebted to you. Well, I suppose that the archers on the overlook could do with some more supplies. Here, take this crate up to the commander at the ambush point. It has some supplies for the men, more arrows and replacement bows. Plus a few luxuries like cakes and letters from friends and family, that sort of thing. The commander has some reward lamps. Once they get this gear, he'll give you some to help with your training. Saradomin be with you, friend.
We're not supposed to talk while we're on duty. You know what? It's not your fault. I might as well have a chat. I mean, this is supposed to be a secure military installation, you know? That's why they told us not to talk. And then they went and wedged the front doors open and put the ladder of all things up along the wall. Do you have any idea how many people I've almost shot when they peek over the wall there? There is a war on. We could be knee-deep in trolls any second now. What are they thinking? Tell me about it. Next thing you know, they'll build one of those house portals up here. Then we'll have adventurers and householders popping out across the ramparts for a stroll. Kids playing with the cannons. Let's see it now.
Mr. Archer, could you and your friends be dears and move? We have a dinner party at 7 and you're ruining the ambiance. Do you mind if we put up some hanging baskets? Only this parapet is frightfully grim.
Yeah, well, we can but hope. Oops, looks like I've been spotted. See you about, okay? We're not supposed to talk while we're on duty. We're not supposed to talk while we're on duty. We're not supposed to talk while we're on duty. We're not supposed to talk. We're not supposed to talk.
terrible. The missus is still insisting on living on the surface like some sort of... Yes! Exactly! Like some sort of tree. So, I'm going to sort this place out myself. At least there's room to have a separate toilet down here. You shut your cake hole! Why did you come to bother me anyway? Oh, is it now? Well, get yourself off then.
I can't complain. It's not the trolls that bother me out here. It's the lack of a decent bedroll. That and having to come to work every day through that jungle gym downstairs. Still, it could be worse. I once spent a week trapped in the storeroom before they got rid of that bloody combination lock. Hey, I can't complain. It's not the troll that I'm having to come to work at.
Still.
Good day. Come to see how things are going. Thanks. These supplies will come in handy. Yeah, have your reward. We still need some more supplies, though. Please speak to Denulf if you have a chance. Not a lot. Up to something, but we'll be ready for them. We still need more supplies, though. Please speak to Denu.
G'day, mate. Things are going great. Sniping at trolls is great work out in the open air. Beats being stuck in a castle all day, mate.